Good morning. Welcome to St. Michael the Archangel Catholic Church. Thank you for your presence with us. If you wish to make a donation to St. Michael the Archangel, we invite you to use the blue envelopes in the pews and place it in the collection basket. By doing this, it will ensure that your entire donation will remain with the parish. We're very grateful for all your contributions. As we prepare for the Mass, we would like everyone to please silence your cell phones. Today we celebrate the seventh Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider today is our pastor, Father Michael Cannon. Please join us in our opening hymn, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling.
Continue in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. And I too welcome everyone to church this Sunday morning. As always, I welcome those of you who are parishioners with us here at the parish. We welcome the many visitors joining us today. If there are members of other faiths, other Christian denominations, you're very, very welcome, and it's good to have you with us. We also extend a welcome to those of you who are joining us remotely this morning from around the nation and beyond our borders. Thank you for praying with us today. And to prepare ourselves now for the Mass. Oh, I'd just also like to welcome Noah Edward Stish and mom and dad and family. Noah Edward will receive baptism following our Mass today. It's good to have you with us. Thank you. And to prepare ourselves then for the Mass, let's take a moment as we call to mind our sins, as we ask God for forgiveness, as we ask God for strength. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that always pondering spiritual things, we may carry out in both word and deed that which is pleasing to you through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. There are some seats here in the front. There's four seats available if anyone wants to take them. Also, if there's space beside you, if you could please move in to allow some of the people who are standing to be seated. Thank you.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to the whole Israelite community and tell them, 'Be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy. You shall not bear hatred for your brother or sister in your heart. Though you may have to reprove your fellow citizen, do not incur sin because of him. Take no revenge and cherish no grudge against any of your people. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord, the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord is kind and merciful
and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that you are the temple of God and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person. For the temple of God, which you are, is holy. Let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you considers himself wise in this age, let him become a fool, so as to become wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness in the eyes of God. For it is written, God catches the wise in their own ruses. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are vain. So let no one boast about human beings, for everything belongs to you, Paul or Apollos or Cephas, or the world, or life, or death, or the present, or the future. All belong to you, and you to Christ, and Christ to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, offer no resistance to one who is evil. When someone strikes you on the right cheek, turn the other one as well. If anyone wants to go to law with you over your tunic, hand over your cloak as well. Should anyone press you into service for 1 mile, go for 2 miles. Give to the one who asks of you, and do not turn your back on one who wants to borrow. You have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies, and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your heavenly Father. For he makes his sun rise on the bad and the good, and causes rain to fall on the just and the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what recompense will you have? Do not the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet your brothers only, what is unusual about that? Do not the pagans do the same? So be perfect, just as your heavenly Father is perfect. My friends, the Gospel of the Lord. Some of you might be familiar with the story of a community of seven monks of the Trappist monastery of Our Lady of Atlas in Tiverine in Algeria. It was movingly captured in a movie called Of Gods and Men. All but one of the monks were captured on March 27th, 1996, by a radical faction of Islamic fundamentalists. They were killed 7 weeks later, on May 21st, much to the horror of other local Muslims whom the monks had befriended and served so generously and so lovingly. The abbot of the monastery, Don Christian, suspecting that such an attack might occur, had written his personal testament 2 years early, to be opened only after his death. The closing words of the testament were addressed to the person who might be his killer. Listen to what he wrote. "And you too, my last minute friend, who would not have known what you were doing. Yes, for you too I say this thank you and this adieu, to commend you to the God in whose face I see yours. And may we find each other happy, good thieves in paradise, if it pleases God, if it pleases God, the Father of us both. Amen. Inshallah." Incredibly, here was the abbot writing to his future murderer, and yet he could commend him to the God in whose face I see yours, as he wrote. The capacity to see the face of God in the face of an enemy is a powerful expression of the teaching of Jesus in today's scriptures. Today's readings begin with a short passage from the book of Leviticus. Now, this book of Leviticus was actually written to give a legal framework on matters of ritual and society and life. Today's words express a call to holiness. The message is simply, because God is holy, all who claim to be believers are called to be holy. And holiness is proven when others come before self, when one loves unconditionally. This law of loving others as self is part of the foundation of what is called the Golden Rule. Paul, in today's second reading, gives us the most profound reason why we should love and respect one another. We are temples of God. God dwells within each of us as individuals and as community. And in our gospel, Jesus himself addresses the same issue. You see, the commandment, "You shall love your neighbor as yourself," from the book of Leviticus, which we read today, was restricted to fellow Israelites. Love your neighbor meant love your fellow Israelites. But in this teaching to his followers, Jesus broadens the rule to include everyone, Gentiles as well as Jews, enemies as well as friends. True disciples
are to love as God loves, he said. Jesus is saying that what must make his disciples different from others is their ability to love even their enemies. In this, they are imitating their Heavenly Father. We're all aware that God shows equal love towards good and bad. Today's words from Matthew attests to this. God makes the sun rise on the good and the bad, and causes rain to fall on the just and the unjust. God does this not because God is indifferent to morality, but because God loves without limits. Jesus did not say it was going to be easy, but he was well aware that violence breeds violence. An eye for an eye was part of Jewish law. But keep in mind that this was originally intended to keep the deliverance of retaliation in proportion to the wrong committed. Jesus believed that even a response in kind was not appropriate for the Christian disciple. And let me finish with another story that I've shared with you before, but it is relevant here. During World War II, Corrie ten Boom was a prisoner in the Nazi concentration camp at Ravensbrück. She survived. After the war, she traveled all over Europe giving talks and urging citizens of rival nations to forgive one another for war crimes. One night after a talk in Munich in Germany, a man approached her and held out his hand in a gesture of reconciliation. Corrie recognized him immediately. He was one of the most hated guards of the camp where she had been prisoner. She froze. Try as she might, she couldn't reach out to take his hand. And as she stood there, she began to pray. Her words, she said, "Jesus, I cannot forgive this man. Please help me to forgive him." And in that moment, she claimed that some mysterious power came over her and helped her reach out to take the man's hand in true forgiveness. And that experience taught Corrie an important truth. That same Jesus who gave us the command to love our enemies gives us the grace to obey the command when we need it. All we need do, she said, is ask for that grace. We may not have to write a letter to someone who may come in the future to kill us. We may not have to offer our hand to a former hated prison guard, but that may be someone's reality in a different situation, as it was Corrie ten Boom's. But Jesus invites us, me and you today, to examine our hearts and minds. I have to ask myself truthfully if there is someone or some people who have offended me that I have difficulty forgiving. Is there an individual or a set of people who have hurt you that you have difficulty forgiving? And maybe a starting point for all of us, asking Jesus for the grace even to begin that process.
And now we stand to profess our faith. And the profession of faith is in the trifold in your pews if you require it. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Today we bring our petitions before our loving God, that we will always make choices in our daily lives to bring harmony and peace to all whom we meet.
For Christians throughout the world, challenged by the call of the gospel to build and widen God's earthly kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of countries and governments in their pursuit of peace and solidarity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For marginalized members of our society, that we may always show the love and respect due to all our brothers and sisters, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Noah Stish, on his day of baptism, that by water and the Holy Spirit, he will receive the gift of new life from God, who is love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the continued guidance and success of our Ministry Center project, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have recently died, especially Gerard Ouellette, Dominic Medico, and Joan Farrar, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Connie Ballier, and Philip Schillick, and St. Michael parishioners, whom we are remembering in a special way during this Eucharist, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the parish prayer line, the intentions in the parish prayer boxes, and our own special intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of love, you whose gospel call challenges us to love, especially our enemies. Hear the prayers of your people who try to walk in your ways. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. As we celebrate your mysteries, O Lord, with the observance that is your due, we humbly ask you that what we offer to the honor of your majesty may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
And let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Heavenly Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, to together with Francis, our Pope, Frank, our local bishop, and all your ministers. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on each one of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Michael the Archangel, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
The Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to pray as one. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
Amen.
And we turn and offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ. Thank you. body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Thank you, Catherine and Sun Young. That was incredible. That was absolutely beautiful. Thank you. And we have a practice here that we offer a blessing at this stage to any little ones who have yet to receive First Holy Communion. And I think we have one or two of them with us this morning. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, when you're so big. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thanks, God. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God blessing upon you too, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Thank you. Almighty God bless you, Abel, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. I love the shoes. Amen. Amen. God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God bless you too, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. Almighty God bless you, Sophie, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thanks for coming up. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Whoops. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Good boy. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for coming up, guys. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
Is that it? It is. So wonderful to have so many little ones to bless. Thank you, parents, grandparents, whoever brought them. It's wonderful, so thank you for that. So now let us stand in prayer. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we may experience the effects of the salvation which is pledged to us by these mysteries through Christ our Lord. Just a few announcements. This Wednesday, hard to believe, is Ash Wednesday, and we will have Mass at 9 in the morning and at 6 in the evening, and there will be a Word and Communion service at 12 noon. Ashes will be distributed at all three services. Stations of the Cross will be held every Friday during Lent at 5 p.m. here in the church. And there's a meeting for all liturgical ministers, ushers, greeters, extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion, and lectors this coming Saturday, beginning here at 9:30 a.m. And it's for all active liturgical ministers and anyone interested in becoming a minister next Saturday at 9:30 in the morning. And just a reminder, if you've just come back and you usually use collection envelopes, the 2023 envelopes are available in the parish office. The parish office will be closed tomorrow Monday in observance of President's Day. Regular hours will resume on Tuesday. And after this Mass, all are invited to stay and join us for coffee and treats outside under the portico back over here. And we again thank the team who have made that possible. How many of you are visiting us this morning? Oh, wow. Maybe a half of you. So it's wonderful to be able to host you when you're here in the area. Thank you for joining us. Is there anyone who hasn't been here before? Oh, first timers. Well, that's wonderful. It's good to have you, and it's great to be able to host you. Thank you for your presence with us. And for those of you who have just come back, welcome back. It's so nice to have so many of you among us once again. So the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass has ended. Let's go in peace to love, to serve the Lord. Have a great President's Day and a blessed week, everyone. Thank you.
And our closing hymn is City of God.
Awake from your slumber, arise from your sleep.
new day is dawning for all those who weep. The people in darkness have seen a great light. The Lord of our longing has conquered the night. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into day. We are sons of the morning. We are daughters of day. The one who has loved us has brightened our way. The Lord of all kindness has called us to be a light for his people, to set their hearts free. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into
Diane.